There is no doubt that strokes are dangerous and deadly. It's the number 5 killer and a leading cause of disability in America.
This Stroke Awareness Month, we sat down with doctors Tareq, Kass, and James Siegler with UChicago Medicine to learn the importance of prevention and early detection.
Well, within the American Heart Association community, we're trying to raise awareness about stroke warning signs and symptoms because, by and large, stroke is a preventable illness, but when it happens, we want to know how to act and how to react to these new symptoms to treat and prevent chronic brain injury.
And when we're talking about knowing what to do, there's that acronym FAST that we're supposed to follow. Can you kind of walk us through that?
Yes, so F is for face. Mm-hmm. So you ask the patient, can you smile for me? And if you see that their face is twisted one way or the other, that's usually a sign of a stroke. A is for arms. So the simple as ask them to raise their arms up like this. And if they cannot raise one side or you raise them and they fall immediately, that's also a sign of a stroke. S is for speech. So if they're not making sense or not understanding you or not able to produce words, or when they speak, they have a slurred speech that you can hardly understand them, that also could be a sign of a stroke. And of course, T is time. Time is brain. We always say that. That means a 911 call. Don't go to your primary care doctor. Don't call your neurologist. Don't let somebody give you a ride to the hospital. That's a 911 call because it's very important to get treated immediately.
And so, it's if any of those are happening, not all of them combined.
Right. Usually could be one or two of them. A lot of time you see multiple showing, but you don't have to see all of them.
Okay, so it's definitely an emergency, a 911 call. So Dr. Siegler, tell us about, in terms of men versus women, who's at higher risk?
Well, it depends on age and depends on demographics and risk factors. So in general, women tend to live longer than men. So in some studies, women seem to be at higher risk. But that doesn't mean that men are not at risk. And you just have to look for vascular risk factors and address them before the stroke happens.
Can you talk about if I do have issues and I need to seek help, a stroke center perhaps, what kind of accreditation you guys have and why you're one of the leading ones?
So we're probably the first center in Chicago to get what we call the Joint Commission comprehensive stroke status. Comprehensive means like it's a one-stop shop. So we are the best of having acute imaging to diagnose patients really fast. Acute treatment, either medical by thrombolysis medications or surgical by a procedure I do personally called thrombectomy. But also we have the best access to rehab, the best access to stroke clinics when we actually, most of preventive medicine happen to prevent stroke from happening in the future.
And what about for people in terms of prevention? Like, how can we prevent this from even happening?
So you should be seeing your primary care doctor and checking your blood pressure regularly. There are typical screens that most primary care doctors will be doing, like checking your cholesterol levels, going through your vascular risk factor history, if you smoke tobacco products or if you drink alcohol in excessive quantities or if you have obesity or other risk factors. Those can be addressed to lower your risk of eventual stroke.
Is this more of, you know, in terms of being at risk for stroke, is this more something that's genetic or more something from factors that you're doing in your life?
That's a great question, and we really don't have a good enough answer for you, but 20% of all vascular risk factors or attributable risk of stroke to vascular risk factors are known. The other 80%, we don't know what causes it. It could be things like the geometry of the arteries in your neck. It could be due to things in the microbiome, as we're learning more about, the things that you're eating, you're exposed to, pollutants in the air. But yeah, genetic risk is certainly a contributor.
And are there advances in the acute stroke treatment, advances in stroke rehab, things that are kind of progressing?
Yes, when we were medical students, stroke was the number 2 killer. So now it's the number 5 killer. So we actually advanced significantly.
Oh, wow.
One of the examples is a newer procedure that got approved in the United States in 2016 called thrombectomy. So we can literally nowadays go from a vessel right here all the way to the brain with a catheter and grab the clot out. The faster you can come to our institution, the faster we can do that, the higher chances of survival and less disability.
So grab those phones and scan the QR code on your screen. You can find more information about UChicago Medicine. You can also book an appointment with a UChicago Medicine stroke doctor by visiting uchicagomedicine.org/stroke or by calling the number on your screen.